Bret is the last remaining member of the once famous Hart Foundation, the stable consisting of Bret Hart, Jim the Anvil, Nate Hart, Owen Hart, Brian Pillman, and the British Bulldog, was a heel stable, who opposed the United States and were extremely unpopular there while being highly thought of in Canada. Prior to the founding of the stable, Bret Hart and Jim Nate Hart had been tag team partners with the name the Hart Foundation back in the 1980s. The stable was wildly successful, with several high-profile feuds, and members picking up all the WWE titles which were in circulation at the time, including the WWF World Heavyweight Championship, WWF Intercontinental Championship, WWF European Championship, as well as the WWF Tag Team Championships. Brian Pillman, famous for his Pillman's Got a Gun segment with Stone Cold Steve Austin, passed away on the 5th of October 1997. He died due to an undetected heart condition on the day of the In Your House Bad Blood pay-per-view. His death shook up the wrestling world. Jim the Anvil Nate Hart left WCW as well and made some appearances in WWE over the years, including on the 15th anniversary of WWE Raw. He also appeared on Total Divas from time to time. He passed away on the 13th of August 2018, although details are yet to be released on the cause of his passing. The British Bulldog returned to WWE following Owen's passing. He wrestled till 2000, headlining shows on multiple occasions before leaving the company. He passed away on the 18th of May 2002 due to a heart attack. It later came to light that he had been training to return to wrestling and had wrestled in tag team matches with his son. Owen Hart continued to wrestle for WWE and returned as the Blue Blazer, a comical superhero role. The gimmick turned out to be a catastrophic mistake, as during the Over the Edge pay-per-view on the 23rd of May 1999, he was being lowered to the ring from the top of the arena. He was supposed to pretend to be entangled just above ring height before falling flat on his face for the remaining little distance to the ring to portray his cartoonish character. Something went horribly wrong, and he plummeted 78 feet to the ring, before falling on the top rope chest first. Attempts were made to revive him, but he never made it back to his feet and passed away due to his injuries. His death sent ripples throughout the wrestling world due to the potential he had that was never realized, and the tragic nature of his passing. Bret Hart and Owen Hart's widow have officially opened up with a passive-aggressive campaign against one another. Recently, in an interview on CBS In This Corner podcast, the Hitman has asserted that Martha Hart is actively trying to erase Owen Hart's wrestling legacy by keeping a frigid relationship with WWE. However, last week, Martha hit back and said Bret's claims were reckless and untrue. The Hitman said, "I think Martha, Owen's widow, she's a very obtuse, square-headed person. I think she's done more to erase my brother Owen's memory than she ever did to remember him. I think it really bothers me that the fans that loved Owen so much didn't get a chance to remember him. You do these kind of things for people are here, left to remember them. I mean Owen, it would never matter to him if he was in the Hall of Fame, but I think that, you know, it would mean a lot to different family members in my family." Martha then issued the following statement on Bret's comments via the Owen Hart Foundation: "The suggestion by Bret Hart that I am erasing the memory of my late husband, Owen Hart, is reckless, irresponsible, and clearly untrue. Bret's comments are rooted in the fact that I have steadfastly refused to work with the WWE to exploit Owen's image for commercial gain. Owen was an incredible entertainer, and I know that his many fans around the world enjoyed his wrestling career immensely. I encourage them to continue to do so, but I am firm in my belief that the WWE was responsible for Owen's death. As a result, I cannot and will not support any efforts by the WWE to profit from Owen's memory. Instead, I, my son Oj and daughter Athena have worked tirelessly to honor Owen through the good works of the Owen Hart Foundation, which has exceeded $4 million in gift-giving and contributions toward scholarships, homeowner bursaries, and other special projects that have greatly improved the lives of so many in Canada and around the world. We have always believed that this is the most fitting public tribute to a man of profound integrity, a wonderful human being who just happened to wrestle. I know that Owen would be very proud of the tremendous accomplishments the foundation has achieved in his name." Bret Hart's comments are disrespectful and cruel. "It is disappointing that so many in the media have chosen to report them without seeking my perspective. Whatever Bret may believe, the fact is that, far from erasing Owen's memory, I have devoted the last 20 years to celebrating his life in a very public way. I can think of very few people who have been remembered so glowingly by their spouse. Our OHF mandate is education, helping individuals with limited resources but unlimited potential." In an update, Bret took to Facebook this week and responded to Martha by saying this past week, I have received multiple requests for comment regarding my recent interview on a podcast and the rebuttal made by Dr. Martha Hart. First of all, I want to express my disappointment in both the Calgary Sun and Calgary Herald for running a gossip-style article and making it front-page news when there are more pressing issues in the world to highlight. You are better than that. I listened back to the interview in question and I specifically want to address Martha's comments about my words being cruel, reckless, irresponsible, and hurtful. Stampede Wrestling was an institution in the city of Calgary. Wrestling was our family business, my brothers, and I either wrestled for my father Stu or worked behind the scenes. Fans packed the Victoria Pavilion every Friday night for decades. Martha has seemed to have forgotten that she attended those same shows before she met Owen. She was by definition, a wrestling fan, that same group Martha appears to look down upon and ignore. Earlier this year, Mark Henry took time during his WWE Hall of Fame induction to specifically address Martha. With tears in his eyes, Henry pleaded with her to allow Owen to be inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. My nieces and nephews were in the audience with tears in their eyes as he expressed how much he deserved to be there with his peers. Fans have told me they had tears in their eyes when they watched the moment on television. Those same fans Martha sat side by side with at Stampede Wrestling and WWE events, those same fans that donate to the Owen Hart Foundation and helped make it what it is today because they remember the joy he brought to their lives and not by how he died. Those royalty checks she receives from the company she says she doesn't want any part of. Those are also from those same fans. To her their tears do not matter, to me that is cruel and hurtful. It is true that Martha and I were close at one time. I was right by her side after Owen's death until she received her settlement from WWE and proclaimed me a pest. Martha later declared herself and her children Harts in name only, called us all black sheep, and ceased contact with the rest of the Hart family. She further isolated from us when we all came together in 2010 to honor our father Stu being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame and participated in a DVD that celebrated our family called Heart and Soul. Owen's children do not have a relationship with his brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews, and cousins. One of my nieces, in fact, named her son Owen after him. I do not know Oj and I wouldn't know Athena if she walked past me on the street. Owen's children only know of their father's family by what is told by their mother. Whatever that may be, painting us all with one broad brush to block Owen's children from knowing their father's family, to me is cruel, reckless, and irresponsible. Owen's tragic accident almost 20 years ago changed our family forever. Martha lost her soulmate and her children lost their father. You have to remember, however, that I also lost my brother. My children lost their uncle. My grandchildren will only know him through pictures and stories. His peers lost a close friend who filled them with endless laughter through long periods on the road. The fans lost someone that they lovingly connected to. Martha is not alone in her loss and grief. The Owen Hart Foundation is a wonderful charity that has raised millions of dollars and has helped many people in its 19-year history. I am not disputing or denying that whatsoever. I disagree, however, that it should be the sole outlet to remember Owen by. This is not just about Owen being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. This is about his wrestling career, his wrestling legacy, his contribution to the business that he loved and honoring that contribution. Owen Hart was a world-renowned professional wrestler, and a damn good one. He was part of the foundation that our family name was built on, not just in the city of Calgary but all over the world. For Martha to want to rewrite history, to refuse to acknowledge or recognize his great wrestling career, to brush off what he, myself, and my father did as that fake stuff is wrong. Owen Hart was a wrestler. The next generation deserved to know how great he truly was. I am happy to hear that my brother Owen will be inducted into the George Tragos, Luthas Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame on July 28 in Waterloo, Iowa. My father and I are past honorees. While I will not be in attendance, the Hart family will be well represented with my brothers Ross, Bruce, Keith, sister Diana, and my nephew Harry Smith accepting the honor on his behalf. Thank you to the board of directors for recognizing his wrestling career, his contributions to the wrestling business, and his legacy. I'm sure the event will be filled with laughter, tears, and an overall appreciation for the man that he was. I can only hope that this is only the beginning.